ओके, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज डिज़ाइन ऑफ एआर डिजिटल फिल्टर्स यूजिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी सैम्पलिंग। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर डीएफटी एंड आईडीएफटी ऑपरेशन। हियर यू टेकन एन एग्जांपल हियर हाउ ए एफआईआर फिल्टर कैन बी डिज़ाइन बाय यूजिंग ए फ्रीक्वेंसी सैम्पलिंग मेथड। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर ए एफआईआर फिल्टर्स डिजायर्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स एज HD of omega. Okay, then the frequency response is sampled for uniform m points. For m points, we are going to consider here where it's already written. Such a sampling frequency from m points. What is the sampling frequency? It is taken as omega m. Omega k is equals to 2 pi m into k. The k is going to vary from 0 to m minus 1 samples. Again, the such sampled desired frequency response for discrete DFT, discrete Fourier transform, it is denoted as h of k. Here, so therefore, h of k is equals to hd of omega, where omega is equals to omega k, where k is varying from 0 to m minus 1. Due to this, if I represent omega as omega k, I can write the equation as hd is equals to 2 pi by m into k. Here, for this, it is in terms of a DFT equation. If I write the equation in terms of IDFT, inverse discrete Fourier transform, the equation is going to be considered instead of h of k, it's going to change for h of n. Here, I wrote here as h of n is equals to 1 by m summation k is 0 to m minus 1 h of k into e raised to j 2 pi k n divided by m. Here n is varying from 0 to m minus 1. This is what the equation is representing FIR filter design in terms of a frequency sampling method. That is what here it is written. Next, when we are going to consider in terms of coefficients of for h of n, what is going for when you are going for to realize the operation for digital FIR filters, here the coefficient should be we are considering as a real terms, but not in all the case it's going to be real. For that reason, there are some complex numbers also going to be considered. For that reason, we are going to take here as complex conjugate pairs. Due to the complex conjugate pairs, here the equation written as h of m minus k e raised to j 2 pi n into m minus k divided by m. This I can write as the same equation is equals to here we are going to multiplying m minus k e raised h of m minus k here in this case e raised to j 2 pi n m minus k divided by m is there. I am expanding that. So if I expand this, I will be getting as h of m minus k e raised to j 2 pi n into e raised to minus, because here is the minus sign, e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by m. We know we already come across this equation that where e raised to j 2 pi n is going to be equals to, it's always going to equals to the 1. So if it is, if this parameter is equals to 1 means, then I can consider this part as equals to 1. So equation 5 is going to become as, instead of writing h of m minus k e raised to j 2 pi n m minus k divided by m, as only of this part here h of here as it is, this is going to be equals to 1. So h of m minus k e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by m. This is the equation what we are going to get. Next, after this, next we are going to consider only in terms of a magnitude part instead of a phase. What's going for first, if I go with the magnitude part, here it's going to be taken as H of m minus k is equals to h of k. Here in this case, the relation based on the fact that magnitude of DFT from 0 to pi is going to be same as the pi to 2 pi. Because of the periodicity property, it's going to remain same for the whole function. For that reason, it's going to be taken as remains going to be same. If it is in this case, so instead of writing here as h of m minus k, I can write the equation in terms of, instead of h of m minus k, I can write as h of k. Same thing, here it is root h of m minus k, this here equation, e raised to j 2 pi n m minus k divided by m. I can replace the whole term to h of k parameter. So in h of k, e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by m. Observe here, we are going to change the sign. Okay, the term, this term what we take in is called as a complex conjugate of h of k e raised to j 2 pi k n divided by m. Hence, h of m minus k e raised to, here I am telling, j 2 pi n m minus k divided by m is complex conjugate of h of k e raised to j 2 pi k n divided by n. That is, I can write based on this whole as the equation h of m minus k is equals to complex conjugate of h star of k. Therefore, the IDFT equation I can write here as h of n is equals to 1 by m flower bracket h of 0 plus 2 summation k is varying from 1 to p real part of, because real values coefficients we are going for that reason, real part of h of k e raised to j 2 pi k n divided by m, where p is equals to, if it is of odd numbers of m, it is m minus 1 divided by 2. If it is of even part, it's going to be m by 2 minus 1. This is about the complex computation of coefficients for FIR filter. This is how a sampling method is going to be used in designing of a FIR filters.